For 2 years, the harmonica player can't eat, but I was a young man. One day, one of my old friends asked me, he said, "How come you don't play the harmonica on stage anymore?" I said, "Well, I'm old now. I ain't got the wind." He said, "I've known you since eighth grade. Maybe you ought to play it with your ass." Sorry. Anyway, I'll keep on with the stories here. I move out to L.A. I'm 22 years old. I'm trying to be a guitar player. I've been there a little while. I get this phone call. Big Mama Thornton needs a guitar player. Anybody remember Big Mama Thornton? So I go, hell yeah, I want the gig. So I drive to the club that night. I walk in the dressing room. I'm 22. I'm the only guy, I'm the only person in the room under 85 years old. I'm the only vanilla fella in the room. I'm feeling pretty self-conscious. I don't know anybody. And I mean, I'm wondering like, boy, what do I say? I'm not, hi, I'm Walter. I'm going to play guitar with you guys tonight. So I go up to Big Mama. I go, "Hello, Mama. It's a pleasure and an honor for me to be here. My name is Walter, and I am going to be playing guitar with you tonight." She looks at me, she says, "Yeah, okay." So then I'm trying to make conversation, and I go, "Mom, we're not rehearsing. There's no rehearsal. I'm gonna jump on stage with you, and we're just gonna play. And what is it you want me to play?" This is the God's honest truth. She got right in my face and she said, "Walter, all you got to do is play like B.B. King. I don't want to hear no rock and roll. I don't want to hear no psychedelic. You play like B.B. King, we're going to get along just fine now, okay?" So we're out on the stage. We're playing the blues like this. She goes, "Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to turn your attention. This boy over here, right now, he's gonna try to play like B.B. King." I looked her in the eye. I walked right up to her in her face and I said, "Hey, Mama.
Thank you.
Well, some years ago, we made a record called We're All In This Together.
Yeah.
And I had an idea to make this record that, you know, I want to do something different. So I figured I'll call up some of my friends. I'll say, hey guys, you come in the studio, we press record, we jam, we see what we come up with. If it comes out really good, hey, we'll release it. If it comes out like shit, we'll release it.
Yeah, yeah.
But it ain't gonna come out shitty when you got friends like on there like Kenny Wayne Shepherd and Warren Haynes, and Sonny Landreth and Robin Ford and Eric Gales and Joe Louis Walker and Randy Bachman and John Mayall and Edgar Winter and Charlie Musselwhite and Barbara Streisand and Michael Bublé. Just the last two are just a joke. The rest of them are on there. And it was an honor for me that year that at the Blues Awards in Memphis it won Album of the Year, so I guess it came out pretty good. Now we did the title track on there with Joe Bonamassa, okay? And right now, I'm gonna bring up this young man over here. This is Mr. Jackson Taylor Lee. Would you please make him feel welcome? And I want to tell you a story that when I was 14 years old and I was strumming acoustic guitar chords and I was singing Kumbaya on Michael Row the Boat Ashore, his grandfather taught me how to play lead guitar. His grandpa. I go to his grandpa's house, I'm 14, I got my acoustic, I'm gonna sing, you know, some Chad Mitchell Trio, New Christy Minstrels. His grandfather has this big ass guitar amp and a guitar and he's going, and he taught me lead. And the interesting thing for me to say right now is his grandpa is that guy right there. Yeah. So he's been hanging out with Grandpa, and I think you gotta see what he's got going here, because I call this young man the future. Come on, Jackson. Show him what you got. We're all in this together. It's so easy. for this guy. Well, it's that time of night where I got to do my little rap here, and those of you who